right, so let's get a little comfortable again. This is J. Tom Gunter, owner of GNS Wines. And I know that you have dealt with this before. Some supposedly wine genius gets up in front of you and pours himself a glass of wine and breaks it down. And I'm not going to say I'm not going to do that. I'm about to do the same thing. But it's just a filler, you know. My show, I have to pull people in and interview them. This is kind of a way for me to also stay true to my craft, which is being able to taste wine and understand what's going on in the glass, in the bottle, and also in the vineyards, and in the hands of the winemaker. So that's what I'm going to do. What we're tasting today is the 2007 Laetitia Pinot Noir. It's out of Royal Grande Valley. I've had it before. I had the 2006. It was first time trying the 2007. I hope that you guys go out and grab it after this review is done. Let's see here. I think that's enough for a tasting, maybe a little bit more, but whatever. I like wine, you like wine, why not drink it? So I'm gonna go ahead and get it on the nose. So just to kind of explain to you, I said in a previous podcast that you don't always want to, you know, swirl your glass. And that is true only in a couple different respects. What I mean by that is when you're dealing with a Pinot Noir from Burgundy, depending on the maker, sometimes when you shake the glass or you swirl the glass, it allows all the aromas to vaporize a lot quicker. Just because it's such a delicate grape in the way they make it, depending on where it's coming from in Burgundy, they can do it in a delicate style. So sometimes you just want it to let it sit in there. This is a little different. This is Pinot Noir from California. They're a little bit hardier, normally, not always, but a little bit hardier. You don't have to worry about the aromas dissipating as fast. So let me go ahead and get into it a little bit. Take off the glasses for you. From Clark Kent to Superman. Okay, so what I'm getting, first thing, is a little bit of smokiness, which is interesting on a Pinot Noir. You don't normally get that, but there is a little bit of smokiness. There's also a lot of dark fruit in this one, which is also an interesting fact. With Pinot Noir, you do get some black berries and black cherries a lot of times. Not black cherries like you'd get in a Cabernet Sauvignon, but definitely a little bit richer, I would say, and not as tannic. So this is definitely a lot of dark fruit, and also some red. You get some raspberry, of course. So there's definitely spent some time in oak, so you get that creaminess. Let's go ahead and taste it and see how it translates to the palate. So I'm sorry, I'm not going to spit it. I know some people do, and I do occasionally, but this is good, so I'm not going to spit it. Great initial attack on the palate. Hits you right in the mouth with a lot of fruit. Long finish. Does not drop off in the mid-palate. It stays pretty consistent. Get acid on the outside, so you know it's going to pair well with food. Very soft and round tannins. They're really so soft that you can't really speak of. The fruit definitely translates to the palate from the nose. There is some floral aspects in there too. I definitely get a red rose, black cherry, raspberry goes away, but there's some darker fruit there. I would say with the oak, you're probably get doing about 20% of oak aging with this, and I'm gonna say it's new oak, because you definitely get a lot of, you do definitely, not a lot, but you definitely get a good amount of creaminess in this. And let's taste again. I mean, literally, it just has so much fruit. Look to pair this with like a flank steak, or you can even do it with filet mignon would run good. Any kind of like red meat would run good. Yeah, very good. Very, very well done. Good kudos to the winemaker and great land for fruit. So until next time, remember, enjoy wine as much as you can with great company. And again, this is J. Tom Gunter, owner of J&S Wines. Salute.